Greetings of the day, everyone. I am Professor Nikita Jackson, and we are going to discuss the topic that is the sedimentation in the core solid fluid operation. In the last session, we have discussed the cage theory. We have started with the what are the basic assumptions, and then we derived the relation. And finally, we are getting C0Z0 is equal to CIZI. That is what the cage relation is. So if you have the graph of the height versus time t, and if you can plot the graph at the different point, you can draw the tangent. And at different point on different tangent, you can find out the settling velocity. So by using the cage theory, we are able to find out the concentration at different height as well as the settling velocity at different height. Now, today we are going to discuss the thickness. So that is ultimately that is the application of the batch settling test data. So that is useful in the designing of the thickness. Now, the thickener which is used in the industry for the separation of the solid from the liquid slurry, and it is a continuous process. So once as it is continuous process, as in the batch experiment, you can see that as the height changes, your zones, different zones that you can see. Where in case of the continuous process, always the height remains constant because it's a steady state process. So at the top, always you are getting the clear water. It is followed by the field solution or the zone of the under settling. Then the zone C, that is the transition zone. And finally, we have the compression or we have the sludge, which is collected at the bottom of the thickener. Now, this is the relation, this graph shows the solid concentration versus the depth. So, as we know that as we move in the downward direction, the concentration of solid is increasing. So, if initially up to this level we have the clear water, so there is no solid concentration. So, you can see here the vertical line. And as you move in the downward direction, your solid concentration is getting increased. And this is your final solid concentration, that is the concentration of the underfloor. Next is, this is what we have already discussed. And now this is the example of the batch thickener. In the batch thickener, we have the cylindrical vessel with the conical bottom. We take the filled material, filled slurry. We allow it for certain time of the period for the settling. And after that time, from the bottom, we have taken out the sediment or the sludge or the solid which is collected, and from the top, we have to taken out the clear liquid. In that, we have the stirrer. In the thickener, the stirrer moves very slowly, and the main use of the stirrer, that is, it will help in consolidation of the solid material. And next, this is how the actual industrial thickener looks like. This is the feed well from where the feed is taken inside the thickener. You can see here, this is the overflow clear liquid which is collected in the annular space between the two cylinders, and then it is collected and it is taken out. Now you can see here also how the industrial or how the large size of the industrial thickener is. So in the today's session, we will discuss how the thickener works, and what is the difference between the batch thickener and the continuous thickener, how we can increase the rate of the sedimentation. So that we are going to discuss in detail in the previous session. Thank you.